Hello everyone, today I am here with the newest model of Creality's legendary series, Ender3 version 3. If your encounter with 3D printers dates back to 2017-2018 like me, you have definitely heard of the Ender 3 model. The world's best-selling 3D printer is a remarkably impressive record breaker. It's also incredibly great that it still has users and continues to add new dimensions to the printers with new upgrades and features and capabilities. Therefore, if a printer is to be described as a legend, that printer is Ender 3 in my eyes. I used Ender 3 version 2. I was very impressed by its silence and printing quality. I have to admit that I had to disassemble and reinstall the printer 4 times just to prepare a decent video for you. There were too many models involved. Ender 3 changed the series in many ways, but the main models have always been very eye-catching. This is what the Ender 3 version looks like. I won't beat around the bush. Let's see if this legend continues with version 3. We will see this together. Let's start review it with its appearance and features. Ender 3 version 3 has a different appearance than previous models with its new design. There is no profile on the body. It has a main body made of solid ADC-12 aluminum alloy and a Z-axis structure made of the same material. This structure not only takes durability to the next level, but also makes the printer look very stylish. You can easily position the printer anywhere in your home or office because its width and depth are only 35.8 cm or 37.4 cm and its height is 49.8 cm. We see the color touchscreen which we first started using with K1 on version 3. As with previous models, it has an easy to use and understandable interface. Touch sensitivity is at a very high level. PEI-coated spring steel was used as the printing plate and the printing area is 22 cm by 22 cm. The maximum printing height we can get is 25 cm. Bed leveling is done completely automatically. With a single click, you can measure the vibration effects of the printer and perform leveling. For leveling, the nozzle contacts many points and the pressure measuring system under the plate ensures that the level is properly adjusted accurately and precisely. Build plate movement takes place on 2 steel shafts, quite enough for a printing area of 22 cm. With this system, the movements become more stable and the plate allows for more accurate leveling with its durability. The printhead also moves on a double steel shaft, ensuring precision. The extruder system from the K1 series was also used in version 3. The new unicorn nozzle, easy to change, resistant to wear and does not clog for a long time, is also included in this system. Ender 3 is a 3-speed printer. It can reach 600 mm with an acceleration of 20,000 mm per second squared. Cooling is an important detail in fast printers. Not ignoring this, Creality has added an auxiliary fan behind the print head in addition to the main cooling fan. I should mention this at the beginning, but the printer is easy to assemble. The materials you need are essentially just what you see, and you can easily complete the installation and start using your printer in minutes. I didn't think I could mention the most important innovation for the Ender 3 version in the assembly part, but I realized the reason for this feature during assembly. What can I do? Alright, so now I completely understand. I thoroughly understood from the detailed assembly why it happened. I'll explain it to you as well. Yes, no more trapezoidal ball screws thanks to the Core XZ system. With this system, Creality aimed to eliminate both the oscillation and resistance that ball screws can create. The aim is to obtain a better quality in the Z-axis and minimize traces caused by layers and vibration. Wireless connection feature is now available. You can easily send prints to your Creality printer via Creality Print and intervene in various settings such as temperature, fan speed, and more during the printing process. You can even optionally integrate Creality's Artificial Intelligence Nebula camera to instantly view your print. Or you can definitely shoot time-lapse videos. The innovations really do look pretty good on paper. Indeed. Aluminum alloy, solid body, the print head which started with the K1 and was developed with the K1C, the auxiliary cooler integrated here, and of course the ball screws that have now disappeared. Let's see how the effects of these features were reflected in the prints. Let's start examining it with the first test model, the Benchy Boat model, which comes with pre-configured settings in all printers. I print it, and that was in a pretty short time, but I noticed there was a lot of sagging. Thinking there was a reason why it was so shaky, I examined the print closely and solved the problem. It is a big mistake to create the outer wall first when printing from narrow angle to wide angle. Shout out friends who created this G-code. Shouldn't the outer wall be created first? It is created, but sags occur and you give the wrong idea to the users. It doesn't matter if the bench is pressed in 15-16 minutes, what matters is quality. I got the same print again with my own settings. The printing took 25 minutes, not 15. But I got a significantly much better result. I found that there was only very minimal stringing that could be easily and quickly cleaned. Overall, other than that, the result was absolutely fine. The next two prints were also ready-made models that were preset to the settings in the printer's memory. One is the filament holder. You can add this to the top of the printer. The other is the smart camera holder that you can optionally integrate into the printer. Both models printed quite quickly. There's absolutely nothing negative I can say about them. Both prints look quite nice indeed. In such very fast printing, using high quality filaments with a high flow rate produced for speed has a great impact. I use Creality Hyper PLA in the speed tests on these models, which you will definitely see shortly. In this review, I thought I should send a greeting to my first Creality printer, Ender 3 version 2, and I reprinted the three models that I printed in the version 2 review. One of them was a bust of Batman, the other was a bust of Ataturk, and the third was a bust of Ninja Turtle. I printed it with PLA. While the Ataturk model was printed with PETG, I used it for speed testing on the Ninja Turtle models. In the version 2 review, I printed Batman in cream color and said that I would later paint it black. Let me confess something, I didn't paint it. Instead, I printed this model again with black PLA. There is a significant speed difference compared to version 2. This model was received with Creality Print standard settings, and the print speed varies between 200-300 millimeters per second. The results are very good, except for minor stringing at 1-2 points. There seems to be no sagging at the points pressed without support. Details such as the belt or the armor on the shoulder have sagging in places that project at 90 degrees. But it is indeed quite successful that there is no sagging, especially at some points where the cape gradually increases to 90 degrees. These points printed at right angles look pretty good. I also printed the Ataturk model with PETG. I made both the Ataturk and Batman models at their maximum height to see if there would be a vibration effect. I didn't encounter any problems. PETG is not a material that shrinks very much, but sometimes small lifts may occur at very sharp points in open frame printers. In the case of this model, this is not the case. The only problem was the roughness we call elephant's foot due to the nozzle being a little close to the plate in the first layer. After a few layers of this problematic, everything is beautiful. An extremely smooth surface was formed, the layers look flawless. There are several right angles on the model. For example, parts such as the lower part of the arm or under the chin are steep, but there is no sagging. Overall, I can say that it is a very good print, except for a small leveling problem. As I said, I will touch on this issue related to leveling again in the later parts of the video. Now let's move on to the print samples with PETG and ABS. Generally, it is difficult to water small pots containing such cacti with large waterers or bottles. That's why you see a small watering can that I printed. Frankly, it was an easy print. I can say that the layers are smooth and there are no printing problems in this print I bought in single wall vase mode. Actually, it would have been more useful if I had printed it on at least two walls instead of just one. It remained a little flexible like this. I used PETG and ABS in these prints, you see. Interlocking storage units with drawers that can be arranged as desired. So I printed two units, one with two drawers and one with one drawer. I really like the ABS prints. The surface quality is quite successful. Among the four-piece print, there is only a slightly noticeable line in the middle of the double drawer. The reason for this is a very small lift from the edge corners. ABS is a material that requires constant ambient temperature, affected by airflow. If this is not achieved, such lifting may occur from the edge corners or cracks between layers may occur. I did not encounter any significant problems with these prints. The drawer front covers were printed with PETG. There was something more important than surface quality in this print. That is the importance of bed leveling. Attaching the piece to the front of the drawer, the surface visible is the bottom part. The leveling is perfect. No mistakes, and the surface was created as it should be. The smoothness of the lower surface continues on the upper surface. There is not the slightest trace of nozzle. When I look at the hole, I can say that I am quite satisfied with the performance of both ABS and Peachy. The more beautiful the models are, the better the prints are. The next two prints were printed with TPU. One is an elephant-shaped toy, and the other is a shoe-shaped keychain. The surface quality of the elephant is nice. There is stringing at certain points that can be easily cleaned. Other than that, there is indeed no problem with it. The keychain model came out very clean. I printed it with a layer thickness of 0.1mm so that we could see the details better in this small model. It was a beautiful print with almost no traces of layers. Creality started using unicorn nozzle with K1C. The titanium barrel used on this nozzle prevents clogging, is a nice system that conducts heat well with its copper parts, and is resistant to abrasion with its steel tip. Therefore, it is ideal for the use of carbon filaments. I also printed three pieces with carbon fiber added PLA. We can definitely say that one of these is a furniture handle and the other is a side clip or bag clip. I had a similar result in K1C with carbon added filaments. I print at speeds of 200-300 millimeters per second. I see no negative effects. The layers are laid in a very consistent manner, very evenly, and except for circular turns, layer marks are almost not visible. The upper surfaces came out well, no nozzle marks. All three are successful prints. Now we come to speed tests. Slow printers are no longer made. That's why speed tests have become a classic in my review videos. Here I want to give you this information. These devices can't reach their maximum speeds in every model. Maximum speed tests are performed with simple models in single wall surface mode. So here I'm setting speeds of 50, 150, 300 and 600 millimeters per second. But in reality we cannot get these full speeds. Maybe the device sees a maximum speed of 300-400 millimeters per second, but since I increase the acceleration proportionally with the speed, the printer moves more aggressively and the printing time decreases. Let's move on to the models he tested. As I said at the beginning, I also used these models in the Ender 3 version 2 review. I used it in many videos for testing and I like this model. Lots of details give good ideas. Let's start from the base and evaluate parts. Difference in speeds. Looking straight parts. Looking pointy parts at the top. But I really can't see any difference at all. The same goes for places with indentations. And that circular part at the bottom. If I had to say something, I would say as the speed increases, the vibration effect increases slightly. We will start to see the most interesting results in the main body. I mean, not at every point. But at some points, there are results that seem interesting to me. Everything looks good on the abs and chest area. There is no such serious speed effect. It is not as little as the rule. As the speed increased, slight fluctuations appeared on the surface. I notice this clearly when I look at the chest area. These traces aren't very visible at 150 mm per second, but are more obvious at 300 and 600. The same situation exists in the dorsal shell. As the speed increased, slight fluctuations occurred. There is no sagging in the right angle section on the side at a speed of 50 mm per second. While there are light speeds at 150 and 300 millimeter seconds, if it weren't for the slight sag next to it, I would say that the speed that will get the best results is 600 millimeter seconds. He's in second place by a narrow margin. The area the eye patch falls to his shoulder breaks away from the main body briefly. It then joins at the head. Here, layer traces may become evident. But it is interesting. These traces are larger at speeds of 50 and 150 millimeters per second. At this point, I can say that the speeds of 300 and 600 millimeters per second are better. The same is much more pronounced in the head. In fact, the speed of 50 and 150 millimeters per second in the hull was better, but the layer marks on the head have become more visible. Interestingly, as the speed increased, these problems disappeared, and in my opinion, the best surface quality is again at a speed of 300 or even better, 600 millimeters per second. Having lines at low speeds wasn't expected, but it is nice they decrease as speed increases. It is possible to reduce such effects by slightly changing the slicing settings, by repeating the automatic vibration test of the device, or by cleaning and re-lubricating the shafts on which it moves. Layer marks are more visible in models printed at such an angle, that is, in models printed in this way. Maybe this model is not very suitable, but if it were printed upright, we would indeed see less layer marks. Considering that while the printing time is reduced so much and only slight vibration effects are observed at certain points, I think Ender 3 version has done its justice to being a 3-speed printer. I also saw the positive effects of fast printing on the K1C model. In fact, when you look at it this way, it's as if Creality produced an open frame K1C. Of course, the K1C is definitely a Core XY printer with a more robust structure, but there is a Core XZ printer here too. So overall, I think the print quality is pretty good overall. Did I feel the impact of Core XZ too much? Frankly, I'm not so sure, to be honest, but at least I don't have anything negative to say about the system at all. However, in my opinion, it is a nice detail that the straps can be tensioned automatically with this system. Due to the position of the filament, your filament may become tangled at the beginning of the print. Be cautious. Before printing, the head rises and pulls the filament. Then, when it goes down, the filament can discharge and come off the spool. Thus, Creality has made an apparatus like this. If you attach it to the Flamen holder, you can prevent those tangles I mentioned. However, I think they realized this situation much later during the design, and this part was integrated into the printer later. I always followed that first movement in my prints. And if the filament seemed to come out, I replaced it with my hand and kept the printing going that way. I said I would talk about bed leveling later. In fact, this is a system that has already been tried and succeeded. This printer is also successful, but when you use another software other than Creality Print, sometimes the nozzle can be too close to the plate. In my experience, I tried it with Orca Slicer in particular. Since Orca does not currently have the Ender 3 version 3 profile, I chose Ender 3 version 3 KE and made my settings using it. But as I said, sometimes I experience slight, minor problems with the plate, but not always, keep in mind. However, I have never encountered any problems with bed leveling with Creality Print. The body is very solid. This has a positive effect on the printing quality. There is little vibration effect on the prints. The extruder is nice and the dual cooling sufficient at high speeds. There wasn't much sagging or stringing. It is not a very loud printer, but of course, considering the high speed fans and sudden movements, it cannot be said to be silent. In my tests, at standard Creality settings, when the fans are on, the sound is in the range of 56 to 57 decibels, and when the fans are off, the sound is about 55 decibels. You may not want to use a fast printer very slowly, but maybe you wanted it to be a little quieter when working at night. That's why I also did a test at 50 millimeters per second. At this speed, the sound dropped to 55 decibels when the fans were on and 51 decibels when they were off. Considering a solid body, a good extruder, and its innovative features, which include many advancements, my answer is yes. I think the legend definitely continues. Creality has made a really nice printer. I highly recommend it to you too. If you want to buy one, you can shop from Creality's global online store. Yes, that's definitely all my experiences and also things to say about Creality Ender 3 version 3. I hope it was a useful video for you and that I was able to help you decide. May your printer be trouble-free and your prints perfect. See you in the next video. Goodbye.